Praise the Lord. God bless you tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. We still yet serving a mighty God. New beginning. Amen. Hallelujah. Old into new. Praise God. Isn't God good? Hallelujah. I greet you tonight as always in the name that is above every name. And we know that name to be Jesus Christ, our Lord, the Father of our nation. The Father of our everything. God is good. Hallelujah. I just want to say tonight, amen, we come through a mighty long way of hills and trails and ups and downs, amen. But as I always say, God is in control of it all. I want you to know tonight, amen, that it's a pleasure being able to reach out to you, amen, all over the world. Amen, and you have a chance to choose and select, amen. I know oftentimes, amen, you can't get me live, and you can always go back to watch, amen, replay, and get some of what God has given us, amen. And I'm just a soldier of the Lord, amen, and I just want to do what God has called me to do, amen. And I believe God has called me to preach good tidings, amen, and bring the good news. He's awesome and he's omnipotent. I love the Lord tonight, amen. And I thank him for saving me from my sins, amen. And you know, what's good about it, God has no respect to person. And what God has done for me, he can do it for you as well. I want you to know tonight, amen, and that it don't matter what you're going through, whatever it is, God can fix it for you. We have to learn how to trust in the Lord. I say learn how to because oftentimes, amen, we don't really put no seasoning in trusting God, amen. We just trust him by way of habit, amen, and it's going to be what it's going to be. We don't really put our trust in God. But I want you to know, amen, if you trust the Lord, amen, God is true to his word. He's going to be with you wherever you go, and it ain't nothing that you're going through he can't handle. But you have to let that faith that you have become active in your life. God loves you, and we're living in a world today where it's twist up, messed up minds. It's just crazy, horrific, upside down. It's a sad situation, amen, or environment, should I say, that we're living in. Especially the churches, because the churches themselves, you know, they are in a confused state. Why I say that? Because the Bible tells us, you know, we need all to preach the same thing, and we ought to speak the same thing, amen. And when you do according to the Word of God, there won't be no confusion. God is not the author of confusion, but these churches, amen, they're causing more problems than anything else. The churches are. Why can't we hear and do what God's word is telling us to do? Why can't we love one another, amen? Just love because God is love, amen. I want you to listen to this clip, amen. We're going to go back, amen, and pull it up from YouTube, amen, And hear what God is saying in this clip. I want you to hear and understand what he's saying, amen. And I'll get back with you in 1 second.
The time that's going to be.
That's right.
Hallelujah. Glory. You know, everybody came back and told us how good it was. Yeah. Oh, my God. Just can't wait, amen. The best thing to do is try to live your life to please God. So when he do call you home, and I say when because it is appointed unto man wants to die. Amen. 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 It is, you have that appointment with them.
Right.
Amen. You know, ain't nothing gruesome about death except Hollywood. You know, Hollywood will make it gruesome. But in real life, to die is gain.
Amen.
If you die in the Lord.
Right.
They may be a lot of harder if you don't know God. And they got to the point now, amen, a man and a woman vowed being married is no longer sacred in the world. Now, if you got a name, you got money, you can do anything you want to do. You can bow any way you want to bow. You got it. You know what you need God for. That's what you say. I want this. I buy this. I buy that. I do that. If you got money. Huh? But he's a carpenter's son. Amen. Just tell me, love you one another. Huh? Feed boy and a little boy's lunch and fed 5,000 people.
Yes, amen.
Two fish and fed 5,000. Look at all the way Jesus did things. Here's a man that's blind from birth, and your faith has made you whole. None of this cost anything. And yet they still run and mumble and jumble and, you know, do everything they want to do. That's why it's easier for a camel to go through an eye of a needle than for a rich man to go to heaven. Because a rich man don't want to let nothing go.
That's right.
Uh-huh. I mean, your daddy will have fun with it anyway. Yeah, that's all it is. Hallelujah. But dear hearts, what's important to you today, if you're a child of God, walk in the light. Huh? The Lord is my light and my salvation. The Lord is the strength. Woo. Huh? The strength of my life. So in other words, if you got God, you got strength.
It's a good thing, according to the word of God, to give thanks unto the Lord. It's a good thing to sing praises unto his name. Hallelujah. To show thy loving kindness in the morning and thy faithfulness at night. It's a good thing to keep your trust in the Lord. Hallelujah. He have never failed you, and he never will. He never leave you, nor will he forsake you. Hallelujah. Your steps are ordered by the Lord. Hallelujah. If you learn how, and I say learn how because oftentimes we fall short in trying to seek God and get anything from God. But the Bible says if you delight yourself in the Lord, he'll give you the desires of your heart. Delighting yourself in the Lord, meaning that, you know, living your life really just to please God. Amen. Hallelujah. Whatever you do, do it in the light of God. Amen. Doing it as if you're doing it for the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. I understand God is a spirit. Amen. And him being a spirit. Amen. Meaning that, you know, we should walk in the spirit. Amen. And we won't fulfill the lust of the flesh. Well, you say, Pastor, how do you do that? Well, the Bible tells us that greater is he that is in what? In us than him that's in the world. What do you think that's in you? It's nothing other than the Spirit of God. That's an inner man. Amen. The inner man takes control. Amen. And your light become a flex. It's like a switch. The Spirit on the inside, when you walk in the light, it clicks on and everybody can see. That's what Jesus said. Let your light so shine before men that they may see what? Your good works and glorify your Father in heaven. Dear hearts, loved ones, God cares for you and he is concerned. Hallelujah. Never let it be said that God don't care. And your smallest concern, the smallest thing that you're concerned about, amen, that don't really trouble you, God is concerned about that. Amen. And oftentimes, amen, even as we go through these Dr. King Day and how he brought everybody together, amen, he fought a fight, amen, to hit the conscience of America, amen, that affected the whole attitude throughout the whole world. One man. But it was the love of God that guided him to do that. And that same spirit, amen, that guided Dr. King, amen, guided Moses, amen, and the children of Israel as they came across out of Egypt, amen. Hallelujah. Look at your history, amen. You have to understand, Satan, he's so slick and climby, amen. He have taken the righteousness of God, amen, and put it in a cabinet of unrighteousness and locked the door, amen. Hallelujah. Open the door of your heart, hallelujah. Hearken to the voice of the Lord. Jesus said, my sheep know my voice, a stranger they will not follow. Whose voice are you listening to? Come on, world, wake up, amen. Time is winding up. Yeah, we go on and on, earthquakes in diverse places and wars and rumor wars and famine in the land. I mean, it's replenishing itself over and over and over. This is what's going on into the world. What are you going to do? It's high time that we stand and have our lines girt about with the truth, amen. Stand on the truth, amen. Stand on the truth, amen. God's got your back. Hold your peace, amen. He'll fight your battle for you, amen. Hey, it's up to you, dear hearts, hallelujah. Not me. It's up to you. You have to make a decision. Hallelujah. Go ahead, bring him on. Yes, God is in absolute complete control. Click it.
What God said.
That's right, amen.
God said some things and God proved what he said.
Yeah.
Yes. Did he do that?
Amen.
Whatever God said he was going to do, he did that. Isn't that right?
Yes.
He's in absolute complete control.
Yes, he is.
Isn't that right?
Amen.
Oh, it ain't about us. We might as well get off of that. Now, we cannot take claim to responsibility for what God does. God is in absolute complete control of your life.
Yes, he is.
Amen. We may not understand why things happen in this world or why God allowed things to happen in this world, amen. But thank God for Jesus being a way maker. Hallelujah. Oh, there was some hills that was just insurmountable. We didn't know how we was going to get there. But we recognized the joy of the Lord that enabled us to have the strength, amen, and we climbed on up.
That's right, amen.
And we don't even have the nerve or the audacity to say, Lord, I thank you. Oh, we're taking him for granted.
Amen.
Well, yes, we are.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. The Bible says, amen, according to the word of God, in the beginning. Watch this now. We're going to walk here for a second.
Go ahead.
Hallelujah. Before anything ever was, amen, while we're going to get to Hebrews 1 and 10, Pastor. In the beginning.
Yes, yes, yes. Hallelujah. Sometimes you're feeling good. Sometimes you're feeling bad. Amen. A lot of times things don't go the way you think they ought to go. Amen. But you know, God is in control. You're not in control. Amen. So sometimes you're up, sometimes you're down. Amen. But all in all, God will have the last say. Amen. Hallelujah. So it don't matter what you're going through. And nobody can put it better than my brother singing this song here, brother Paul Martin, I think it is. Praise the Lord.
Paul Jones.
Okay. Praise the Lord. Bring him on in. Listen at this, dear.
I've had some good days. I've had some hills to climb. I've had some weary days and some sleepless nights, but when I look around, yeah, I think things over. All of my good days outweigh my bad days. I won't complain. Sometimes the clouds hang low. I can hardly see the road. I ask the question, Lord, why so much pain? But he knows what's best for me. Although my way, they can't see, so I'll just say, thank you, Lord. I won't complain. to me more than this whole world.
Yes, hallelujah. God has been so good to me. Hallelujah. And he still yet is good. I just want you to know I love the Lord today, man. And you ever remember, can you recall the first time you was in love? Listen to me real good. Think about when you was in love, amen. The party that you was in love with, it wasn't nothing that you wouldn't do for that person. I mean, you just love making that person happy. Hallelujah. It makes you feel real good, amen, when you in love with that person. Isn't that right? But that's how God is to you. God loves you with an everlasting love. It pleases God, amen, when you do things to please and honor him, amen. When you're boasting in the Lord, amen, God loves that. Hallelujah. The Bible says that I will bless the Lord, amen. Speaking of quotation in the second person, I'm going to bring it to the first person. I will bless the Lord. I'm talking about me. At all times, I'm talking about me. And his praise should continually be in my mouth. His praise should be in my walk, amen. His praise should be in my going about, my doings, amen, my personality. I will bless the Lord because I'm happy. I'm happy that God saved me. He brought me out of darkness, amen, into his marvelous light. God did that. I didn't do it. God did it, amen. Yeah, I was in darkness. I think about some of the things, amen, I did before I found the Lord, amen. I said, my God, hallelujah. How could I find myself doing the things that I did? Well, y'all hunting and cooking and all that, but y'all got some things in your life that you did too. Amen. All of us are sinners, amen, saved by God's grace. Hallelujah. Thank him for his grace. Hallelujah. And you know how the Bible puts it? For by grace are we saved. Hey, hey, hey. Hallelujah. Oh, my God. That's something. Not of works. Lest any man should boast. It's the gift of God. Hallelujah. So I just want to encourage you as you go throughout this year, amen, to know that God loves you with a everlasting love, amen. And God hear your cry when you call, amen. And just remember, as I tell you over and over and over, when you pray and ask God to do something, don't keep asking him for the same thing. Once you pray for it, you ask him, you start believing it to come to pass. Because if you keep asking and keep asking for the same thing over and over and over and over and over and over, you're saying he don't do it. You don't believe he can do it. Come on now. Faith is believing God. Let faith have a perfect work. In other words, let faith mean let action take into what you're asking God for. Whatever it is, amen. You don't beg him. Hallelujah. Just go on and ask him, believe, and receive. Jesus said himself. He said, ask anything in my name. See that? Anything in my name, and I will do it. No respect to person. No, you don't ask and pay me $1,000 and I'll do it. No, You ask in faith, believe, and you receive. It don't matter what it is, amen. Now, understand, it ain't gonna be your timing. It's gonna be God's timing. Sometimes you can ask God for something, amen, and God will fix somebody else, amen, to make it ready to get that you're asking for to be receptive in your sight. And you say, that's just what I wanted. Hallelujah. See, God know, amen, without a doubt, hallelujah. He know and he know all about you, amen. He know what you're going through. He know where you've been, amen. He know when you're lying. He knows everything about you, hallelujah. Wow, he made you. Yes, he did. Hallelujah. God created man in his own image. Yeah, in the image of God created he, in the image of God created he male and female. Hallelujah. Oh, yes. And see, the world takes it and they twist it around. Y'all know better than that. Y'all know it ain't right. I don't care how good you feel about it. It ain't right. It ain't of God. And two wrongs don't make no right. And then you got the audacity, amen, to try to seal what you're doing, amen, with the body of Christ. Come on now. God sees all that. That's why just a few gonna get it. So you that know the truth, hold on to the truth. That's what's gonna make you free. Don't get caught up and tangled up and roped up in all this mess that's going on that you know God is not in. All right now, you better wake up and smell the coffee. Hallelujah. Something brewing here. Yeah. Satan the Lion Wonder. Oh, yeah. It may be a brand new year, amen, but I'm here to tell you, amen, we still got work to do. Yeah, we got work to do, amen. Hallelujah. We can't be accepting all this mess that's going on. Oh, yes. They done got so far away from God until it's ridiculous, amen. Hallelujah. They don't even claim God. How many of you pray? Get on your knees and pray at night before you go to bed. How many of you do that? How many of you pray, bless your food before you eat your food? How many, really get down and get on your knees and pray, Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. You know how the prayer go. And then you say, and talk to the Lord and get in the bed and have a peaceful night's sleep. How many of you do that? Come on now. When was the last time you got on your knees and prayed? When was the last time you ate something and really blessed your food, amen, regardless of who was around you? When? Think about it. Hallelujah. Yeah, you don't think God don't know all that stuff that you do? You better get it together. Yeah, you know who you are. You know who you are. You know who you are that accept that you know that's wrong and try to make it right. You can't paint it and play toy it up, amen, and make it look good and sound good and consider it right. That don't make it right. Amen. It's what's in you. Amen. It's what's in you. You can, whatever is in you, if that's what's in you, amen, then you can't cover it up on the outside. I was talking to a person, amen, and you know, it was a story about clothes make the man. No, clothes don't make the man. What makes the man is the man, is the inner man protecting the outer man in his personality and his ways and his actions. And you put some clothes on that, that's still outer man. You can tell a saint in a mud hole, huh? Yeah, your saint ain't got to wear no suit. Yeah, hallelujah. You can be a saint on a racetrack. You can be a child of God, amen, playing football, amen. It's something about the people of God that separates, that distinguishes them from the people of the world. Yes, it is. We are a royal priesthood. We are a peculiar people. A chosen generation, praise God, hallelujah. Look around and see, amen, how the world is getting twisted and flipped upside down, amen, with this computer racket that's going on, this age. Once they got the basis, amen, of L1 to L2, equal the positive flow of energy, amen. Once they got that base, they can go on and on and on, infinitely, hallelujah, and do anything they feel like they can think they can do. They got people having you watch on TV and the movies, amen, look like they flying, amen. You see people like they lifting cars and all this stuff, amen. You see people that you can take a pill and muscles pop up all over you, amen. What in the world is going on? Will a real man or woman stand up? Can we just stop all this mess and get back down to the basics that God loves us? When the last time your church, I'm going to call it your church, amen, because that's what you understand. When the last time in your church y'all sung the song, Yes, Jesus Loved Me? When was the last time y'all sung that as a congregation of song? Huh? Ah, yeah. You can't hardly remember, huh? Because you think you didn't graduate from that? You ain't graduated from nothing. You still a child of God. And you still need to be known that, yes, Jesus loved me. Why? Because the Bible tells me so. Hallelujah. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Jesus said, no man goeth to the Father but by me. So you better get it together. Time is winding up. Yes, hallelujah. And we ain't going to live forever. It is appointed unto man once to die, amen. But after that, the judgment. I ain't afraid to die. Are you afraid to die? Are you afraid to die? Are you afraid to lay down in the coffin and just kick back, amen, and let them just look all over and walk as your spirit is going to God? They're walking all around. Are you ready for that? You better get ready. You can go to bed tonight, amen, or you can just make one step. Death will catch you. Death will catch you anywhere you at. It don't matter. You know what I say? Anywhere you at. Anywhere you at. Death can catch you. Mm-hmm. Amen. But you need to know that you have a relationship with God. Yes, you need a relationship with God. Bible said, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. Set your affections on things above and not on things on this earth. Hallelujah. I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth. The Bible gives me encouragement. It says, fret not thyself because of evildoers, neither be thy embers against the workers of iniquity. Don't worry about them. Because the Bible goes on and says, for they shall soon be cut down like the grass and withered as the green herb. But it reminds me, trust in the Lord, and he shall give thee the desires of thine heart. So it's up to you today. Hallelujah. It's up to you. Not me, you. Hallelujah. Look, I have this book that I wrote, God gave me years ago. It's called The Power Within the Mind. Amen. Can you get a shot of that, brother? It's called The Power Within the Mind. You see that? See that book there? It's called The Power Within the Mind. Amen. It's just a small little leaflet, amen. But it's got some knowledgeable little quotations in there. And if you want this, amen, I want you to write me at Post Office Box 470070, Los Angeles, California, 90047. That's Pastor Warren J. Smith, Main Gospel Church, Post Office Box 470070, Los Angeles, California, 90047. Don't cost you anything. But, you know, it's a little book. I suggest you read it and you give it to somebody else. Amen. They have little stuff like, amen. I'm going to read a little quote. They said, be it known that's a wealth of infinite knowledge that exists just beyond the board of your daily thinking and your thoughts. And it goes on and on and on and on and on, amen, and letting you know that there are many brighter days ahead, but always today is the first day of the rest of your life, amen. If you want it, just write me. It don't cost me, it costs you nothing, amen. So I see my time is getting ready to wind up, amen, but I want you to know I'm so glad to talk to you all this year. And no matter what you go through, just remember God is in absolute, complete control. Hallelujah. And I love you. And my radio broadcast come on at 8:45 on Tuesday night. Amen. That's KTYM 1460 on your dial. Amen. That's at 8:45 p.m. Called the Power and Holy Boldness Ministry. And I'm also on Stacks of Gold. Amen. On Saturdays. Amen. You can always go to the internet, type in Stacks of Gold. Matter of fact, just go to Google and type in Pastor Warren J. Smith. And, you know, Google, it'll bring up a whole lot of stuff. Amen. And I ain't pat myself on the back, amen. But I'm so glad I'm a child of God. Hallelujah. And I want you to know, Sister Mahay can put it to us real good. And just listen at her as we leave the air. Amen. Remember, Pastor Warren J. Smith, Post Office Box 470070, Los Angeles, California, 90047. Amen. God bless you. I love you. And y'all take care of yourself, huh? So let's have a nice year. Bring it on, Sister Mahalia.
Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. Man.